Hello, my name is Jesus Medina and I'm the creator of KO Method, which is a holistic approach to fitness and self-defense training. I'm also the owner of Seabreeze Fitness, which is located in Costa Mesa, California, which is where we're now recording this. Today I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how to do a combination. Mainly what I want to teach you guys or show you guys how to drill is a double hook. Alright, there's a certain way you got to do a double hook in order for it to be an effective double hook. With this combination that we're going to do, it's a 1-2 evade, come in, and then a double hook. Alright, and obviously that last evade to get out of danger. I'm going to teach you guys how to do it economically, how to basically be economical with every motion that you do. That way you don't get tired, you don't reach fatigue, and you're very effective with it, with the misdirection, with all that stuff. You're going to control distance, you're going to evade properly, and stuff like that. So you're going to divert your attention from your opponent to various places so that you can get those hooks in, especially the last deadly hook. Alright, so the way it's going to go is say for instance, he's going to initiate. Alright, so he's going to initiate the 1-2. When he initiates the 1-2, most of the time, the 1-2 is the easiest combination to counter. Alright, the reason being is, stand on this side. Alright, stand your boxing stance. Alright, look at where the 2 is at. Alright, to throw the 2 is way back there. Yeah, it could be fast, the 2 stop right here. Alright, so now he has to go back that much far. So right here, whether I get hit or not, I'm going to swing to the last bit of C in his head. Alright, so if he doesn't move where his head is at, move your head, I won't hit him. Alright, go back again how you were. If he doesn't move, and I'm still blinded from him hitting me with that, whether he hits me hard or not, it's going to make me either flinch or close my eyes from trying to take that shot, whether it's a hard one or not. And once again, I'm going to swing to the last place where it's at, and I'm going to hit him because he's not going to move if he doesn't move his head. All right, so that's the reason why the 1-2 is the easiest one to counter. And trust me, they're going to shoot either a jab or right back at you, the same exact thing you threw out. All right, so he's going to initiate this part. So he's going to initiate the 1-2, whether he hits it or not, boom, boom, evade. All right, that's what he's going to do. So throw the 2, boom. Notice how he's a little bit forward, shoulders forward to throw all that leverage into me. Alright, whether he hits me or not, he's going to drop automatically to change the level of his head so I won't hit him, and he's going to go back. Control the distance. There's no way I'm close to his punch. Look how far he is and he didn't even try hard. Alright, alright, so come a little more forward. So, now from there, go again, boom, boom, and wait, and I'm going to hit, and he's going to slip. Alright, look where he's at right now. Alright, all he's going to do, let's go over here. Alright, so do it again. Boom, boom, bam, evade. Alright, so right there when he slipped, alright, look where he's at right now. So he's just gonna pitter patter on my side, side crunch to that side, and then bring that shoulder over to hit me. Bam. Alright, if he's quick enough, I won't even have time to react, to block. Even if he is quick enough, but I'm quick enough, or meaning any other opponent that he might be facing, go ahead, slip. Alright, if he's quick enough, that's why I mean a pitter patter, because if I'm quick enough, go ahead, hit me for down here. I'm going to go down here. Whether I see it or not, whether I block it or not, I'm going to go down. What does that mean? I'm wide open here, boom, for a side hook. All right, that's why it's going to be effective. Now, what I meant about the double hook, it being a certain way in order to be effective, you can't throw power on the first one and expect that the second one's gonna have power as well. Why? Because of lactic acid. You already got done doing 2 shots for 1. You're in that chaos, that danger, and you're gonna go back and then come in. All that takes up lactic acid, takes away oxygen if you don't know how to breathe properly. All right, if you're not training yourself to breathe, which most of you don't, trust me, I don't care who you are. All right, not even GSP, they don't even do it. All right, they don't train the breathing. All right, they train the breathing to recoup, but they don't train the breathing during. Alright, trust me, look it up, you'll find out that all of you don't train it. I don't mean to sound arrogant, it's just I think outside the box. I don't look at the obvious. I don't train what's obvious, you know, what's in front of you. I train the mind, and that's what we want to do right now. I'm training the brain, I'm training him to learn strategies so he can control distance and all that good stuff. Anyhow, so this is what it's going to look like. Obviously, the 1-2 is the simplest, alright? We're not going to drill it that long because the 1-2 is simple, but let's go ahead and drill it. The main thing is that he drops, so that he changes the level of his head to get his head out of danger. Make his head a difficult target. Here we go. Let's do that for a few seconds. Alright, that's it. Come this angle. Alright, again. Watch. I'm aiming for his head. All right, and look how much he barely moves, and I'm snapping fast and realistic, and I'm even lunging out almost unrealistic like, because I want to reach him. And look how much far he's, how far away he's from my hip. Here we go. Look how far he is, all right? I can get even nowhere near close, and he was still in his position of power. It's just the way he was started. All right, he started like this, and then he ended up like this, and he's still not leaning back, meaning like this. You never want to be like this. Your head behind your butt, you're naturally going to compromise yourself. Your center of gravity, your balance is going to take over. Your body's going to take over. Self-defense mechanism and instinct, you're going to try to catch yourself. And even if you don't try to literally catch yourself, you're going to lose focus, lose concentration, trying to keep your balance from keeping your head behind your butt. So don't do that. Anyhow, here we go. One more time. One, two. Alright, so now we're going to work on the Spartan shove, alright, which means come in, which is the not only a slip, it's actually a slip Spartan shove, almost like basically you're trying to throw your shield into your opponent, alright, so here we go, one, two, come in, then stop, and then relax, here we go, alright, that's all it is, so remember, don't be afraid, stand right here, right in front of me. Alright, so watch his body, alright? The midline of his body, alright? You can barely see the midline of my body. That's not important right now. Look at his. His midline is where I'm going to be shooting, where I seen him start the, initiate the combination. So nice and slow. Boom, boom. Alright, it's still, except for the slip. He's way over now. I shot at the midline where his head was, but look how he slipped. He still came forward, but naturally when you come forward with that shove, you kind of shift your head to the side. All right, let's do it again, now realistically. All right, that's simple. And he's wide open, and I was shooting straight in the middle because that's where I seen his head, but he slipped it over. All right, here we go. All right, so you can't tell, I go back and stop with the slip right now, with the evade. Boom, boom, boom. So if he's right there, come this way, let's do it again. All right, again. Boom, boom. So if he's right there, I can reach right there, all right? But look, and I'm not compromised, but since he's slipped and he's over here, you best believe I'm freaking compromised, all right? For one, I just let out all that air. Two, look what's open over here. Boom, boom, head. I'm gonna get really, really dazed if not knocked out. Most people will, all right? I don't care who you are. If you get hit in that manner, trust me, I don't care what you think, all right? The body is the body, right? Think about it. You're losing a lot of oxygen. Your body, your brain needs oxygen. That's how you lose your equilibrium a lot quicker, all right? And don't forget about that hook that's coming. That's gonna mess up equilibrium big time. Anyhow, so now that he got that down, I'm gonna go ahead and work on the pitter-patter hooks, all right? So we're gonna stop that for now, eliminate that. We're gonna work with the double hook. All right, that way he doesn't throw the first hook with power, because if he does, he's gonna, the second one is nowhere going to be nowhere near fast, and he's probably going to get countered right away with an easy uppercut, anything. All right, let's go ahead and show him. So slip and stop on the two right here. Boom, hit it. All right, if he hits, I can crunch and I can probably take that shot easily. Most people can, all right? It's going to hurt, but you can have a chance of blocking it. But if he goes too hard with this one, all right, now I have a chance to come in because it's going to slow him down, come over. Boom, I can go like that. I hit him in his uppercut and take that shot. Yeah, I'm going to be hurting. But before I go down, best believe I'm going to try to take him out as well with me, all right? So if he throws it hard that first one, trust me, I'm gonna beat him. Well, anybody can beat anybody to their second shot. So what it's supposed to be is just a quick little feint, even with the leg. Boom. All right, that's all you're gonna do. You're gonna loop it over.